Bonjour tout le monde, bonne année. Alors qu'on débute une nouvelle année, je sais que bien des gens s'attendent de voir ce qui leur attend en 2021. Même si on est bien loin d'en avoir fini avec la pandémie, je veux commencer aujourd'hui en vous disant qu'on a des raisons d'être optimistes. Deux vaccins sûrs et efficaces ont été approuvés au Canada et nous avons déjà commencé à recevoir des doses de ces vaccins au cours des dernières semaines. Notre gouvernement a travaillé sans relâche pour livrer près d'un demi-million de doses de vaccins aux provinces et aux territoires le mois dernier, et ces efforts se poursuivent. Ces vaccins permettront de protéger les gens et de sauver des vies. C'est pourquoi il est essentiel que les provinces et les territoires mènent leur campagne de vaccination le plus rapidement possible. Le gouvernement fédéral prend en charge le coût des vaccins et des fournitures nécessaires pour les administrer et, par l'intermédiaire du Centre national des opérations, qui est soutenu par les Forces armées canadiennes, nous assurons la coordination des aspects logistiques du déploiement des vaccins partout au pays. Since Canada approved the first COVID-19 vaccines just a few weeks ago, we've already delivered nearly 500,000 doses to the provinces and territories. We're on track to have well over 1 million vaccine doses from Pfizer and Moderna by the end of January. And by September, we'll have enough doses to vaccinate every Canadian who wants a shot. This pandemic will end. We will get through this. Better days are on the horizon, but to get there, we need to keep holding on. Je l'ai dit et je le répète. Ce n'est pas le temps de prendre des vacances à l'étranger. Nous devons maintenir le cap. À ce sujet, je tiens à faire le point sur la prestation de maladie pour la relance économique. Le but de cette prestation est simple, de fournir aux travailleurs un congé de maladie payé s'ils n'en ont pas de leur employeur. Cette prestation existe, par exemple, pour un employé d'une épicerie qui doit s'isoler parce qu'il a été en contact avec un collègue qui a testé positif ou si lui-même devait présenter des symptômes. Cet employé n'a alors pas à choisir entre subir une perte de revenus ou de s'isoler pour se protéger des autres. L'objectif n'a jamais été d'envoyer un chèque à ceux qui décident de partir en voyage à l'encontre des avis de santé publique. Mon message à ceux qui sont allés dans le Sud est clair. Vous n'aurez pas droit à cette prestation. Elle n'est pas prévue pour vous. À ceux qui ont été fâchés en lisant les reportages en fin de semaine, je partage votre frustration et votre indignation. On est en train de corriger la situation rapidement. Je sais que vous avez fait beaucoup de sacrifices dans les derniers mois, mais ce qu'il faut retenir pour l'instant, c'est que les personnes qui voyagent pour des raisons non essentielles n'auront pas accès à la prestation canadienne de maladie. On dit aux Canadiens, depuis mars, d'éviter tout voyage non essentiel. On continue de marteler ce message sur toutes les tribunes. Et il y a une quarantaine obligatoire pour tout le monde qui revient au pays, sans exception, avec des conséquences légales très sévères si elle n'est pas respectée. Les mesures et les contrôles qu'on a instaurés aux frontières depuis le mois de mars sont parmi les plus strictes au monde. C'est important pour protéger nos proches, nos travailleurs de la santé et pour faire en sorte que nos hôpitaux ne soient pas débordés. Canada has long had some of the strongest travel measures in the world. Since March, these rules have helped save lives. As new strains of COVID-19 emerge, as cases skyrocket in countless countries, this is the time to double down on keeping you and your family safe. Starting Thursday, to be eligible to return to Canada, travelers must have a negative COVID-19 test before boarding their flight. This is in addition to the long-standing mandatory 2-week quarantine once people arrive. Officials are reviewing travelers' isolation plans, and if the plan is not up to par, the travelers will have to quarantine in a federal facility. Earlier today, I also spoke with President Ramaphosa of South Africa, including about our work together on fighting COVID-19 and the global response to this pandemic. Canada and South Africa have long worked as partners to keep our citizens safe and build a healthier, brighter future for everyone. As we face this pandemic, we will continue to stand together. This includes on fighting the virus and on ensuring that no one gets left behind as we rebuild. On public health in particular, Canada is taking the steps needed to protect Canadians and stop the spread of COVID-19. We've put in place additional screening and enhanced measures to respond to new challenges wherever they occur around the world. We've been very clear. No one should be vacationing abroad right now. But if you still decide to travel at your own risk, you will need to show a negative COVID-19 test before you return, and you must self-isolate for 2 weeks when you get back. You need to take this seriously. Not following the rules could mean real consequences, including fines and prison time. Let me also be very clear about the Canada Recovery Sickness Benefit. It is not intended for travellers who are quarantining when they return from holiday. This program was created to give people sick leave if they needed it and otherwise wouldn't have one from their employer. It's not there to pay for someone's post-vacation quarantine. We'll have more details soon, but anyone who travelled for non-essential reasons will not be able to access the sickness benefit. So many people gave up so much more than just a vacation over the holidays. There's a reason so many Canadians made those tough but responsible decisions. There's a reason so many Canadians did their part. It was for the people around them, for the senior that is better protected, for the frontline worker who's safer on the job, for the small business owner who could look with more confidence to reopening. We can't let the sacrifices we've made over the holidays and over the last 10 months go to waste. This afternoon, I'll be speaking with local business owners in BC and PEI who are working hard to keep employees on the payroll. Later, I'll also have a chance to drop in on a virtual classroom with students in Edmonton. As a former teacher, these classroom meetings are among my favorites. Our kids are doing an incredible job of not just adapting, but also looking out for each other. So to all the kids doing virtual school this year, and with a lot of you starting up this week, you're doing great. Keep it up. And remember, even as you're trying to figure out how to get virtual school going, this is tough for your parents too. So maybe give them an extra hug at the end of the day and, you know, maybe for once do the dishes without being prompted or asked to it. We're all in this together, and the more we can all help each other out, the better we're going to make it through this. Right across the country, people of every age are doing their part. Now is not the time to give up. With rising cases, many provinces that have already made tough decisions will have to continue doing so, whether with local restrictions or province-wide shutdowns. It's not easy, but it is necessary. Our government will be there as a partner for all orders of government as they make the right choices to keep people safe. Working together is what will get us through this crisis, because we're not out of the woods yet. On New Year's Eve, there were over 8,400 new COVID-19 cases reported in Canada, and the day before, there had been almost 7,500 cases. These aren't just numbers. Hundreds of families are grieving someone they lost over the holidays. Thousands more are worried about a loved one in hospital. Countless paramedics, nurses, and doctors are struggling to keep up with new patient after new patient. That's what's at stake here. That's why your choices matter. En portant un masque, en gardant vos distances et en évitant les rassemblements, vous assurez votre sécurité et celle des autres. En utilisant l'application Alerte COVID, vous contribuez à freiner la propagation de la maladie. Prenez par exemple jeudi dernier, quand des centaines de personnes ont entré leur code unique dans l'application après avoir obtenu un résultat positif au test de dépistage. Ce simple geste empêchera des centaines d'autres personnes de contracter le virus. La lutte contre la COVID-19 est un travail d'équipe et ensemble, on va réussir à freiner cette pandémie. Au cours des dernières semaines seulement, notre gouvernement a apporté un soutien supplémentaire aux communautés qui en avaient besoin. Je parle notamment de la présence de la Croix-Rouge dans les établissements de soins de longue durée du Québec et celle des Rangers canadiens au sein de la Première Nation des Kwanishit. Et nous sommes prêts à en faire plus s'il le faut. Across the country, and especially in Ontario, long-term care homes are facing extremely concerning outbreaks of COVID-19. This is unacceptable. Our elders, our parents and grandparents built this country. They raised us, and they deserve the very best possible care. We've already lost too many elders in long-term care. The tragedies of the spring must not be repeated. So as we have been since March, our government is here to support provinces in getting the situation under control in their jurisdictions. Already, we've been in touch with the government of Ontario and stand ready to provide additional targeted help. Today, just like when we first deployed the armed forces and the Red Cross during the first wave, our top priority is keeping people safe. I'll be bringing up long-term care homes with all premiers on Thursday at our First Minister's meeting, as well as shared work on vaccine distribution and measures on borders and travel. We're all in this fight together, and our government will always be here to do our part. An armed forces deployment, boosting testing, isolation measures, this can be the difference between local outbreaks becoming a crisis or becoming under control. I think of when the Shamattawa First Nation in Manitoba requested emergency support to respond to the COVID-19 outbreak in their community over the past weeks. The federal government deployed the Canadian Armed Forces, who worked side by side with the community on testing, contact tracing, and isolation capacity. And today, cases are a fraction of where they were, and the community continues to work hard to stop the spread of the virus. À tous les gens qui travaillent sur le terrain, que ce soit au sein des Forces armées canadiennes ou de la Croix-Rouge, dans un hôpital ou dans une organisation communautaire, merci. Vous faites un travail incroyable. Nous allons continuer d'être là pour vous. Dans les semaines et les mois à venir, notre gouvernement continuera d'apporter de l'aide aux ceux qui en auront besoin. L'année 2021 sera meilleure que 2020, je vous le promets, mais elle sera tout de même pas facile. Ensemble, on va passer à travers. Bonne année. Happy New Year, everyone, to all of us.